Okay, we're going to talk about pending invoices. So a pending invoice in QuickBooks is an invoice, right? It's an invoice transaction. However, you mark it as pending here, okay? Now, marking it as pending, what it means is it becomes a non-posted transaction, all right? So when would we want to use this? So perhaps in our QuickBooks file, we don't use sales orders and estimates at all, okay? We just do invoices. And I have an invoice that I started, but I haven't finished it yet. So I'm going to make it pending in here until I can mark it as final. Once I can finish it, then I mark it as final. So when it's pending, meaning non-posting, that means it does not affect, there's no financial repercussions, right? So I'm not hitting sales. It's not going to show up on my P&L, things like that, because it's a pending non-posting transaction. Now again, if you're using estimates and sales orders, pending transactions probably aren't super effective, okay? Because usually we use a sales order as an example because we want it to tell us or affect or drive demand of our inventory, right? So a sales order drives demand or affects inventory. When we add something to a sales order, right, an item, it tells us how many are on a sales order that need to be fulfilled. So, you know, therefore we only have 50 available because we have 24 on a sales order, even though we have 74 on hand. Okay, but a pending invoice, if you add a inventory part to a pending invoice, all these pop-ups. So let me go ahead and choose one here. So right now we have 188 on hand, 100 on sales orders, 88 available for sale. So if I add 50 to a pending invoice and say save, let me go look at my quantity available now. It's still at 88, right? So it's really not effective when it comes to any kind of inventory tracking. So that's why I say the most effective usage of it is if you're not using estimates and sales orders, you're only using invoices, then it's okay. You know, maybe you just use it as like a holding place, basically. All right, so no effect on inventory, driving demand for inventory, no effect on the accounting. So why would we use them? Now, again, we do have customers that use them. So as an example, people who use field service management, which is the work order management software that connects into QuickBooks. So what happens is that when the work order, when field service management, you know, the tech goes out in the field and they, you know, do the work on the water heater and they use six or seven parts and they have some labor time. So when that invoice comes across from field service management, it comes across into QuickBooks as an invoice. Okay, that's the transaction. That's how the third-party application connects into QuickBooks. So because it comes across as an invoice and we want the opportunity for accounting to review those invoices before they actually got to the clients, we have them come across as a pending invoice. Because that way, right, I can come in here and run a report and show me all my pending sales, open up those sales, and, you know, review them, mark them as final. So that's a good example when, you know, an outside source is sending data in. We want it to come in as a pending invoice, and then we can mark it as final once we've reviewed it and send it off to the customer. Okay. Besides that, I would just really steer clear of them. I have some customers who also set them up like pending invoices to remind them in the future that they need to invoice their customers, but there are much better ways to do things like that, right? By memorized transactions. So there's much better ways to do things like that. So just be aware, it is something that's in there. So once we're done with this, so let's say we reviewed it, or I went in and I added my additional, you know, items that I needed to add, the additional charges. Basically what we do is then we come in and we click and we mark it final. Now once we mark it final, oops, it's going to tell me I have to assign a site because I have multiple warehouses turned on. Once I mark it final, then of course it does affect the inventory, right? Inventory would go down cost of goods sold will go up, accounts receivable goes up, sales goes up, right? So that it does affect once you mark it final. Now, one other thing that I like to point out is that if you are going from a sales order, because I have had customers try and attempt, you know, kind of use this as like pick, pack, ship type of thing. So if I go from a sales order and I say I'm going to create an invoice, okay, and then I mark this invoice as pending, even before, like I can, before I even save it, I just mark it as pending and I select save. Now, what that does is on the sales order itself, it closes the sales order out, which is what we want it to have happen, right? We shipped it. But because I went in and marked this invoice as pending now, it doesn't show that I removed those parts from my inventory. Okay, so let me go through that process again. So we're looking at the sales order, and right now we have 50 on hand, right? Or 50 available, 74 on hand. So I create the invoice, okay, and I mark it as pending now. Now when I go in and look at my quantity available, right, it still shows I have 74 on hand because I now marked it pending, but now it shows me I have 10 quantity available for sale because the sales order is closed out, right, so it doesn't pull any more of those. But this invoice is pending and it doesn't drive that demand for inventory. So you just want to be really aware of that. It's not the best the best process for trying to make it, you know, pick, pack, ship type of thing from a sales order. Generally what we do with those is we select on the sales order itself, right? We'll create a custom field that has a drop down that says shipped, and then we run a report for all shipped sales orders. And then accounting creates the invoices from those, okay? So I just want to point that one out as well. All right, so those are pending invoices, rarely used, but nice to know it's there.